Taking a trip to the Kansas City Zoo with Jan Armstrong means going to a zoo that many of us wouldn't recognize today.
If you went through all those bushes, you'd find the old units where the bears were in.
And to understand the zoo she sees, you have to see the fascinating chapter in her life, a true story about a lady and her bears. Jan Armstrong hand-raised four polar bears in the 1970s, a girl, a boy, and twin girls, from the moment they were born until they were ready for zoo life in a house right on zoo property. It once stood where the elephants now stand. She shared the home with her husband, Jack, who was the zoo's director at the time.
I miss being with the animals, you know, because it was really, it was a privilege, because when you're their family, then you see the normal behaviors.
Armstrong never had her own children. She says her children all had fur and feathers. But the polar bears made her especially unique. She is the only woman that we've found who successfully hand-raised four polar bear cubs. And just like the mother of a newborn human, Armstrong experienced the sleepless nights and constant vigilance.
Now, the little polar bears, of all the mammals that I had anything to do with, the mammal infants, were the most helpless for the longest time.
Really?
They didn't open their eyes until they were about a month old. And then it was 3 months before they started walking.
Somewhere in between there, they got teeth. And while most of her polar bears were relatively docile, she remembers Choo Choo, her first cub, was rather impatient and used those teeth.
She wanted to eat 5 minutes ago. So I learned to adjust to her personality.
And that's what Armstrong did for each of her babies. She felt it was important to have them exhibit all of their natural behaviors, and she always made sure they had a companion. Borealis, for example, had a baby hyena as his friend. While Armstrong says she loved all of her animals, Borealis was different.
Oh, he was quite a character. Yeah, Borealis was special.
Armstrong checked on her babies after they were all grown up at the Kansas City Zoo.
I'd be walking by them every day.
And they knew she was checking on them.
They knew who I was by my smell.
After her husband left the zoo, the new director closed the polar bear exhibit and sent the bears to other homes. We learned Choo Choo was donated to a zoo in Germany in 1990 and died at the zoo in 1996. She never birthed cubs of her own. The other three cubs, Borealis, Polera, and Aurora, went to zoos in Japan. Those zoos later closed. We contacted the Japanese polar bear program manager, who told us that unfortunately he had no further records on them. The Kansas City Zoo donated the mother and father bears, Esky and Mo, to Ringling Brothers Circus in 1980. At the time, the Ringling Brothers used polar bears in their show. The circus is no longer operating, and there are no additional records. While parting with her cubs wasn't a happy occasion, Armstrong always knew the bears would move on eventually.
The idea was to raise an animal to be the best whatever it was, and my emotions didn't come into the picture.
Today, Armstrong continues to check on the animals. She's a passionate donor of time, talents, and finances to the Kansas City Zoo, and the caretaker in her hasn't gone away with time. Armstrong met one of Berlin's keepers while we were visiting the zoo with her.
I remember with the little twin polar bears, the last ones that I raised, that there was a snowy day and took them out, and they loved sliding on the snow.
It was a walk through a memory and a glimpse of a legacy she built at the Kansas City Zoo. And although that chapter of her life ended, the zoo she knew 50 years ago is still alive in her memory. Abby Eden, Fox 4 News.